pretty straight. What has this, you know, week done in terms of the belief system for this group, considering how crucial this time of year is? Have you noticed an uptick, maybe, and a boost?
No, this is 9 of 10, either 8 of 9 or 9 of 10 that we've played awful well. So this is just the accumulation of good play. And I said to people before, we either played well and won or played poorly and lost. We hadn't reached a stage where we'd played well and didn't win. And we went through that stage when we went into Montreal and stuff like that, and Philadelphia. But it started to turn the ball where we're competing at a really high level right now. And not every game is going to be clean, but if you compete at this level like we're doing, you give yourself a chance against anybody every night. And now we're on the other side of these one-goal games. And, you know, we're going on the road where we play better on the road, quite frankly, than we do at home.
Ken,
the things, Curry's goal. When your coach sees a guy score his first goal, what goes through your mind?
Well, you're really happy for him because you know how, especially what he's done. Like, this is a guy that was an East Coast Hockey League player that stayed with it. And then got an American League contract, stayed with it, got an NHL American League contract, and now he's sitting up in the NHL and he's got the trust of the coaching staff. I mean, this is quite a story. And you're so happy for him. You know, when we had Patrick Russell up, you're happy for him. Joe Gambardella, same thing. I mean, these are guys that they don't come with any ego. They've earned the right to get what they've got, and you're really proud and happy for him. And for me, for Josh, we trust him. We trust him because he's got great competitive instincts on the ice, and I see no reason why he can't be a good player.
Ken, this morning, Alex Chiasson mentioned that this was an opportunity for the rest of the group to step up with the absence of 97. How did you feel like the team fared in that regard?
Well, I told the guys, we don't need a hero. We need everybody's best. And it wasn't the cleanest game today. They're a hard team to play against. They've got a lot of foot speed. They've got a lot of depth, and he uses the depth, especially up front. So there was a lot of pressure on us, but I thought we competed at a high level throughout our lineup, which is a good sign.
You guys acquired Sam Gagne last weekend. How important is it that he's finding off success and he's able to, you know, contribute on the score sheet each night while getting accumulated with the new team?
Well, I don't know where we would be without the addition of him right now, to be honest with you. I mean, he's an NHL player. He helps us in every avenue. Obviously, he's playing more minutes now than he's ever played probably in the National Hockey League. So he's in a really good situation for him and his family right now.
So, Ken, when they go to video replays on that last play in the last minute, does the coach even have any idea? Is that a goal, no goal? Do you have any idea?
You're looking at it on your feet, and if it's no goal and they take the headsets off right away, you feel comfortable. But as that thing was going on and it's delayed over there, now you're getting nervous. So now I'm thinking, do I have to make the call of goalie interference? But I kept seeing the guy's stick whack our goalie and turn him sideways. And it looks obvious to me, but when it takes that long, Jim, that's when, as a coach, you get really nervous.
How'd you see the last hit by Corey Perry on Darnell Nurse?
Somebody just mentioned it here. I haven't seen it yet, so I can't comment.